Good morning and welcome to our service of Remembrance. Thank you for joining us online. When it comes to the moment for the 2 minute silence, those who are able are invited to go and stand outside their houses in their streets as a mark of respect, so we can see one another paying tribute to those who've fallen in the course of war. But now let us begin. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may live together in freedom, justice, and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability, and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember today, with thanksgiving and sorrow, those whose lives in world wars and conflicts past and present have been given and taken away. Let us pray. Ever-living God, we remember those whom you've gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
George Hine Adcock, James Frederick Lester Adcock, Charles Andrews, Frederick Andrews, Percy Andrews, Frederick George Armstrong, Ernest Herbert Baldwin, Lawrence Alfred Howard Barrow, Frederick Batchelor, Horace Batchelor, Bertie Brazier, Frank Bunce, Charles Burgess, Herbert Butterfield, Aubrey Spencer Kane, Harry Leslie Kane, Frederick George Charge, Frederick William Clark, Percy Thomas Clark, Leonard Cook, Charles Cooper, George Coote, Leonard Coote, Stanley Coote, Wilfred William Coote, William Coote, Frederick David Curl, Horace Charles Day, Sydney Arnold Bell Davis, Percy Draper, Joshua Dyer, John Featham, James Fensom, Leonard George Fisher, Alfred Flitton, Arthur Flitton, George Flitton, George William Flitton, William Ernest Flitton, Charles Frost, Frederick Ginger, William Ginger, Horace Godfrey, Percy Godfrey, Alexander Grant, Edgar Harris, Horace Harris, Alfred Hobbs, Percy Impey, Lawrence Frederick Jackson, Roland Hill Kingham, George Kitchener, Arthur Frederick Lee, Elijah Peacock, Charles Pedder, Harry Pedder, Leopold Randolph Richardson, Alfred Dennis Riley, Cecil Clement Robinson, Walter Robinson, Frederick Rolt, Walter John Rolt, Jack Sylvester, Thomas Skinner, Francis William Smith, William Souster, Ernest William Stevens, Clarence James Thodey, Harry Thomas Winnett, Jack White. 1939-1945, Albert George Bandy, Douglas Arthur Batchelor, Frederick Charles Harvey, Leslie John Horwood, Glenister Leslie Morton, Vincent James Seymour, Alan Lane Tucky.
They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
Good morning. I'm Second Lieutenant Stonelake of the Royal Artillery, and I'm from Markgate. What does remembrance mean to me? Remembrance to me is that time to pause and reflect on those that have made sacrifices, both physically and mentally, for the freedoms that we take for granted today. Whether that be in the two great wars or in more recent conflicts, it all provides us with the liberties that we take for granted. And to me, that is worth remembering.
When leaves like guineas start to fall, and sycamore and elm begin red tears to shed, then autumn's in, and summer gone beyond recall. At this time of remembrance, we think on all those who have lost their lives in service to their country. We remember the fallen from the two great world wars. Blow out, you bugles, over the rich dead. There's none of these so lonely and poor of old, but dying has made us rarer gifts than gold. These laid the world away, poured out the red sweet wine of youth, gave up the years to be of work and joy, and that unhoped serene that men call age. And those who would have been their sons, they gave their immortality. Blow, bugles, blow. They brought for us, for our dearth, holiness, lacked so long, and love and pain. Honour has come back as a king to earth and paid his subjects with a royal wage. And nobleness walks in our ways again, and we have come into our heritage. We think on the fallen from all wars in all conflict zones. We remember them. We remember their families and friends. We remember the survivors. Grant to them all peace, healing, and light. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for each other at this renewed time of lockdown. We pray for the lonely. We pray for the elderly. We pray for the sick. We pray for the NHS. We pray for our leadership. We pray for the scientists. Let us support and care for each other harder than ever, no matter what our differences. Let us remember that people have died in war so that we might all lead better, fulfilling and safer lives. Accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us pray for God's blessing. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth and all people, unity, peace and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you, and remain with you always. Amen.